Hello, pocket knife community, knife lovers, knife enthusiasts, interested viewers. Folder here. I want to do a video on the PKW Wharnetac. This knife's been out for almost a year now, I think. Just looking back at some videos, looking at the ages of them, and but I just got mine recently, and I am extremely happy that I did. You know, sometimes you see certain things and you know the type of thing, the type of tool that you like, and then if you haven't held one in hand, sometimes you have the opportunity to hold one in hand, sometimes you don't. But I'm a collector and a content creator and a vlogger, and I get stuff and then I put it out there, and I definitely want to tell you about this. If there's anybody that I can't say enough about this knife. Let's just get into it. Let's just get into the specs on it. This is an 8-inch knife. Okay, overall length is 8 inches from end to end. 4.5 handle, 3.5 blade, and it weighs 3.6 ounces. Okay, that's the short version. Okay, but the details of it are just absolutely incredible. It's a Wharncliffe blade. And it's a hollow grind, and I measured it. The micrometer gave me 16 thousandths behind the edge. Micro milling on the titanium handle is absolutely gorgeous. I love the way they did the pivot here. They made it one side accessible, and this is just flush. Reminds me of the Quiet Carry Drift. The way they actually did the reversible pocket clip on this, I am not mad at that at all. Could they have just left that out and would it have been okay? Yeah, because the lefty community in pocket knives have developed they know about frame locks and they're amazing at flicking with and deployment with their weaker hand. So they could have done it, especially because it's a frame lock, but they didn't. So that was very thoughtful. And that's good. And to me, I don't mind that at all. Like I said, the pocket clip is incredible. Does its job. And, so this knife is just a free flow design on the handle. You know, there's no downturns. There's no dramatic downturns on the handle at all. So the ergos are very neutral. Fits a lot of different hands. You know, there's also a flats spot right up here, no front finger choil, flats where you can use it, and it's probably got some of the best, if not the best, jimping in the industry. The jimping on this knife is absolutely spectacular. They hit a home run with this jimping. Spyderco does really good on jimping most of the time, but it's not even as good as this. This is very good. You know, it's just amazing how they got this figured out. Precision Knife Works got this figured out. Listen, I handle a lot of knives, but I guess there's a lot of other knives I haven't. So maybe there are other knife manufacturers that also have jimping figured out pretty good. Like I said, I own a lot of knives. And of the knives I own, this is probably, if not the best, definitely in the top, in the top five, four, three. Maybe three knives I own the jimping on this knife. If not the best. So this company, PKW Precision Knife Works, the owner is Dan Hosen. The Wharnetac Blade Steel is CPM 20 CV. And they the heat range is 59 to 60 HRC, based on the card that they gave with the knife. I'm going to just put it out and say this. I am absolutely blown away by this knife. It is very high quality. The reverse flick on this thing is absolutely sick. It might be the fastest knife I have reverse flick wise. I don't know if the sound is coming out over on my camera, but it sounds insane because it flicks so fast. knives that don't have, you know, certain knives, depending on the locking mechanism, crossbar locks, and, you know, even the Spyderco Manix too, they have locking mechanisms that ride on the tang. So can you flick them out fast? Yeah, but not fast as something like this that has just zero release. Once you come through, let's see what the detent is on this. Yeah, once you come through, it's almost freely firing out with nothing, you know, weighing it down. And then the blade itself is nice and small, and the deployment hole is just absolutely, it's perfect. So the deployment without the reverse flick does require a pinch, at least for me it does, because there's no relief here on the handle to kind of get to it to do a slow roll with one finger. So you do have to sort of pinch. Once you got the pinch going, then you can just slow roll it out with one hand normally. So it's like the, it's like a pinch and then a slow roll, or you can just have fun and fire it out reverse flicking it all day. You know, it's the only form of deployment it has. There's no flipper tab, there's no front flipper, no rear flipper, no thumb stud. Just that, and it doesn't need it at all. The lock bar is absolutely perfect. You know, access to it's great. The tension on it is great. It's tuned very well. The relief for the lock bar is on the inside of the handle, keeping the outside clean. You know, I'm gonna say that, you know, for a sub $300 knife, this knife is as good as any for what it is, for what it does. Its mission, it accomplished, right? To be a lean Wharnetac hollow grind, you know, this type of form function, pinch grip, you know, detailed cutting type of tool. I mean, this thing is absolutely, I really like this knife. And like I said, it's going to go in my collection, and it's going to be in my top 10, definitely. Definitely going to be in my top 10, might be even in my top 7. You know? That's how good I think this knife is. But that's just my opinion. Some, you know, someone else might take this and be like, oh, yeah, it's nice, but I'm not blown away by it. I am. I mean, we have knives like one of my favorite knives, the Koenig Arius. When you really look at this knife and how amazing it is, you're not getting one of these for under $1,000 right now. And what are we talking about here? Micro milled titanium. M390 steel, 20 CV steel, same thing. Frame lock. Custom titanium mill pocket clip. Hollow grind. I understand these are two completely different platforms of knife. I get it. You know, you're talking about a big drop point like this, the Koenig Arius, but what I am saying is that you're talking about a knife like the Koenig Arius that in the pocket knife community is highly respected. There's nobody I've ever known or even heard of that doesn't herald this knife. I mean, how could you? Guillotine, drop shut action. Like, you cannot get anything better. Listen to the sound of this thing. I mean, are you kidding me? Koenig Arius. And honestly, my opinion, this is the best one. The one with the micro milling like this on the handle is incredible. Like, it's impossible. I could stick my hand inside a ton of grease and it wouldn't show one fingerprint on this knife. Amazing. Well, guess what? So, yeah. I mean, you're talking about this knife is 3 or 4 times expensive as this. So, I put this in the same class. My opinion. It is in the same class as the Koenig Arias, in my opinion. That's how good this knife is. I am so happy I have this knife. Yeah, really am. Very satisfied. You know, money well spent. Yeah, so I'm not going to keep going back and forth over it. It's fantastic. If you're my tastes have changed a little with knives. Like I said, I'm tending more to really like the slicey stuff, man. The stuff that really, they're really prolific cutters, you know. The stuff that's less tough, you know, more of a tool, more of a precision tool is really what I'm sort of gravitating to right now. But I like knives, all of them. So, you know, you got the big crazy stuff and you got stuff like this. You know, I think it's, if you're a collector, it's good to have a little bit of, you know, it's good to have a little bit of all that stuff, you know. But this is where it's at. So, yeah. So, all right, that's all I got. You got the Precision Knife Works, the Wharnetac. Right? Wharnetac, Wharnetac. Almost like a heart attack, Wharnetac. Yeah. All right. That's all I got. Thanks.